Hello everybody, I'm Céline Romand, and welcome to my office. I will show you how I do to review an esophageal high-resolution magnetry. So this study was performed in a patient before anti-reflux surgery. Our regular protocol consists of a period without swallowing, a 30-second period, then we perform 10 swallow of 5 mm water in a supine position. We are also doing a multiple rapid swallow a test, which consists of 5 swallow of 2 mm water less than 4 seconds apart, and finally we are performing a rapid drink challenge, which consists of drinking 200 mm of water as fast as possible. The first things to do is to expand the dressing. This is what I'm doing, and according to the system you use, you may have to perform thermal compensation. This is the case here, so I put the cursor at the end of the tracing, and I will go here up in the tools to select the thermal compensation. Here we are, the thermal compensation is done, so now I can review my study. So I will start with the period without swallowing. I am opening the frame. Here we are. I will adjust the landmark for the upper esophageal sphincter, around in the middle of the sphincter. I will then adjust the landmark for the lower esophageal sphincter, or the EGJ, here in the middle, here the proximal border, the distal border, and I will adjust the gastric marker. Here I can look at the resting pressure, which is around 30 millimeter mercury. So now I'm done with the analysis of the period without swallowing. So I will look at the swallow. So I have to move here to the next swallow. So the first swallow. So here the DCI is below 450. So this is an ineffective swallow, otherwise everything is normal. I will go to the next one. So the next one, normal DCI, normal distal latency. The latency, distal latency is measured between the opening of the upper esophageal sphincter and the CDP, which is here, and here the distal latency is normal, as well as the IOP. So we have a normal swallow. I move to the next one. So here are the next one, the DCI is low. So we have an ineffective swallow, and in the case of the ineffective swallow, we do not measure actually the distal latency. So let's have a look at the next one. Here, the next one, normal DCI, normal IRP, normal distal latency. So this is a normal swallow. The next one, again, we have a small DCI. So this is an ineffective swallow. This is the second one. We are going to the next swallow. Next swallow, again, a low DCI. Here, this one is intact. The DCI is normal. The distal latency is normal. The IRP is normal. I'm going to the next one. Normal swallow again. Normal swallow. And the last one is a normal swallow. Once I review all the swallows, I have to look at for abnormal pressurization. So to do so, I'm going in the tools here, and I will select isobaric control, and then here I can with my cursor move at 30 millimeter, because we are looking at pressurization at 30 millimeter. I will go through the 10 swallow, and here in this case there is no abnormal pressurization, so we can go here in the report. Now here we are, and if I look at the IRP, the mean IRP is around 10, which is normal. I will look at of my swallow. I have 40% of swallow which are ineffective. So it means that in total this study will be considered as normal, because we have 60% of normal swallow. And I look at the mean DCI, which is 662 in this patient. I will close the report. I will now look at the multiple rapid swallow, which is here. And so we look at the swallow at the contraction at the end. This is this contraction. I will measure the DCI of the contraction. So to do so, I will adjust the isobaric contour at 20. And I will search for the smart mouse, which is here. I'm going to the smart mouse, and with the right click, actually I can select my contraction to look at the DCI, which is 400. And if you remember well, the mean DCI was around 600. So it means that the DCI of this swallow observed after the multiple rapid swallow is smaller than the mean DCI. So it means that the contractile response after the MRS is not normal in this patient, or at least there is no positive contractile response in this patient. By the way, you can see that there is a complete inhibition of swallowing during the contraction during the multiple swallowing. So to finish, I will just look at the rapid drink challenge. This is here. So I will just look at for pressurization. So for the pressurization, we look at 30 millimeter mercury isobaric contour. Here we are, and here you can see that there is no abnormal pressurization. The only thing you can see here is a little bit increase of pressure, but it might be due to a cough actually in this patient. You can see that there is an EGJ relaxation. And you can also see that there is no contraction after the rapid drink challenge test, which is not in common even in normal subject. So in this patient, we have a normal swallow without contractile response with after the multiple rapid swallow. And in this patient, there is no contraindication to perform an anterior surgery. I thank you very much for your attention.